If you're wondering why my cheeks just constantly look red or pink in all my videos, it's because I'm constantly embarrassed. It's obviously a lie. I'm drunk. Hi, Paul Talkers. Happy Saturday to you. It's day 7 of vlogging every day until VidCon. Still haven't missed one. Once again, I'm going to answer a question that was left in the comments, and today's question came from amytasukada, who asks, I wonder what does Paul listen to? The thing about that question is that I listen to different types of music for different purposes. For my hobby of lindy hop swing dancing, wherein I also DJ, hence the old school player shirt, I will listen to a lot of jazz from the 20s through, well, through today, but in the era of the music from the 20s through the late 40s. However, when I am not DJing a swing dance, I don't necessarily listen to jazz very much. I used to listen to jazz all the time in high school, before it was cool. Is it cool now? Do I know what cool is? What is cool? Anyway, when I'm not listening to music for swing dancing, generally speaking, I like stuff that has a decent melody, interesting lyrics, so it's not just the same words over and over again or nonsensical words over and over again. But even with just listening to music for fun, my feminism still comes into play. If I figure out that the lyrics of a song sound sexist or misogynistic or objectify women in some fashion or perpetuate the patriarchy, I don't want to like that song. If I don't know what the lyrics mean, I might be able to enjoy it, but as soon as I figure out that the lyrics are like that, I'm not down. Similarly, if the musicians themselves are horrible people, I will try not to listen to their music. Like when I found out about Chris Brown and Rihanna, I stopped listening to Chris Brown's music, even though up to that point, I had really enjoyed his music. I don't want to support that as part of my culture. I don't want to support people treating women crappily as part of my culture. I'm not perfect about this, like, and it is very possible that the songs that I like right now, many of them may be full of crap that I just haven't recognized yet. And if I figure that out, I will take those songs that I'm listening to right now out of my rotation as well. Let's go through my Pandora likes and we'll find out together. Pandora, iPod. So one song that I like right now is Ariana Grande's Problem with Iggy Azalea. Ed Sheeran Sing. I've been enjoying this one for a while, but I haven't stopped enjoying it. It's Time by Imagine Dragons. I still like Cher Lloyd's Want You Back for the grunt at the front, even though the lyrics are not my favorite. I like the grunts. I'm not immune to liking Iggy Azalea's Fancy. I like Nicki Minaj. I unapologetically, unironically enjoy Kesha. And I don't like all of his songs, but there are some Usher songs that get me moving. Clarity by Zed. A few Zed songs, actually. This is nice because it's got Zed and foxes. I'm actually not sure how they pronounce their name. Is it Churches? It looks like Chaverches, but I think it's Churches. The Mother We Share. Oh, good stuff. And I kind of like a lot of the musicians who come out of the Disney family, like Zendaya with her Replay. Is that a good sampling? I don't like a lot of profanity in my music because, I don't know, I just don't. I like listening to stuff that makes me want to bob my head and move my body and sing along. I don't know, maybe all my examples were boring, but you asked, amytasukada, so I hope that you like that answer. Now, somebody who does have pretty cool, interesting taste in music is Amber of Amber and Stuff, who, by the way, is my YouTuber of the day. I did a segue right there. I'm assuming that she has pretty cool taste in music because all the stuff that I've heard in the background of Amber's videos on her YouTube channel, it's pretty good stuff. I wanted to recommend her channel because I can't watch one of her videos without being cheered up because it's just so fun to watch her videos. She talks about mental health issues. She talks about her queerness, being a pansexual. She talks about being a nerd fighter and VidCon. Plus, she does this thing where when she gets excited, she goes like this.
It looks creepy on me, but it's so cute on her.
So hurry and check her out to get that horrible image out of your mind. And then we get to the part of the video where I tell you why I'm doing VEDUV, and it is to bring your attention to this, the crowd fundraiser that I'm doing to give money to RAIN, the Rape Abuse Incest National Network. And this org is one of the best in helping people deal with sexual assault, women and men. Links to everything that I've talked about are going to be in the doobly-doo, except for all the music. Just search YouTube for the music. And that's it. I hope that you liked this video. If you did, please give this one a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Feel free to share this video with your friends if you want to demonstrate how uninteresting my musical taste is. And if you have any questions, suggestions, or comments for me, leave them below. If nothing else, please tell me something that matters to you because I want to know what matters to you. And as always, thanks for watching.